carols and one range of stones, and everyone gathered around the piano to sing carols. Mrs. Redding says that she didn't sound very well, but she sounded just fine to me. It's Mrs. Smith I wonder about. I'm sure she'd never sang quite so loudly if she knew how she sounded. Mommy let Suzanne turn the pages, and she managed not to look off the piano every time. In spite of everything, though, it all sounded rather pretty. I'm sure that I must love to hear people sing about her, she and Mrs. Smith.
Oh, yes. Even Mrs. Smith. But the Bible only says to make a joyful noise unto the Lord. I know that we can't all gather around the piano, but there's not a thing in the world to stop us from repenting. So let's all find our places and sing some of the old familiar carols.
Thank you.
old, great, and timeless song of Christmas. What a shame, however, it is that in most of our world, carols are becoming a thing of the past. A good illustration of this took place in Detroit when a local television personality questioned some children about Christmas. He asked one little girl what her name of her favorite Christmas carol. And she replied, "Well, I only know two, Jingle Bells and Grandma Got Run Over by a Reindeer." The saddest response, however, came when he questioned a young boy as to why we celebrate Christmas. The boy paused for a moment, shrugged his shoulders, and said, "I don't know. They haven't told us yet. They haven't told us yet." Imagine celebrating Christmas without even knowing why.
December 24th, dear diary, tomorrow will be finally Christmas. My house is filled with all kinds of delicious smells. Mom and I have baked all plate pumpkin pie.